entry was about microgrid, pay-as-you-go, and blockchain governance. And so our workshop actually built upon the work of, well, assumed that team one and two, team two was dealing with like the really difficult issue. So team one about like educating people about what is the blockchain and how does it work. And team two about actually providing the right business model in order to build the microgrids. So our team decided to focus on the next layer, which is how do we actually connect microgrids together and how do we actually optimize the flow of energy within a microgrid. So we started from the observation that there is in Africa more and more households that are investing in solar system. But the problem is that oftentimes you have single houses that do not have access to those solar systems because it's too expensive or just they do not have the will to do this. And on the other hand, some of those houses which have the power do not always use it all the time. So during the day, perhaps they are actually not taking advantage of this electricity. And so there is obviously an incentive to connect all those households together so that they can share the energy. And so by creating a local microgrid, we can create a better quality of service and cost effectivity by enabling or by inserting the management or the governance with blockchain technologies. So this requires a particular grid infrastructure, which comes with two meters, one that calculates two smart meters to calculate the consumption and the production of energy. And then the idea then is that every producer can register into the system and define what kind of power generator they have so that the system can assess what will be the expected energy production that can be provided by this household. And then people then can submit what is their pattern or what is the expected consumption that they will have over the day. And the system automatically will assess what is the excess capacity that can be sold on the market through the grid. On the other hand, there is the consumers, which will also submit their own pattern of consumption. So they will bid for a particular slot of time in which they actually require energy. And the idea is that then the blockchain can automatically match those different bids and perfectly allocate the consumption. So for instance, if you have five households that need electricity, but they do not actually all insist on the same time slot, then they will be shared so that the capacity is always optimal. And in case there is a lot of people that really want to use the electricity at this particular point in time, then it will be those that have bid the highest price that will actually get the electricity first. And then there are, of course, cases in which, because of some natural conditions, perhaps it is like really cloudy and rainy, and therefore the expected electricity production is actually not fulfilled. And so in this case, the system that we designed enable people, the consumer, to actually define whenever they are bidding for those slots, whether those are really important to have like fixed slots in which they really need the energy at this point in time, or whether this is actually more flexible. And in the case in which there is a scarcity of power in the grid, then the people that that require the electricity, that because of some kind of application that is important at this moment, they can buy the energy from those that already purchased the energy, but actually that do not insist so much on having it at this particular point in time. And so this creates a secondary market for rebidding over the energy consumption. And then finally, there is the question of course, we have multiple microgrids, but it is also possible to connect those microgrid together in order to have a much more broad system. And here again, the blockchain can be useful in the sense that every single local grid can be all the preferences and all the orders that have been placed into a local grid can be aggregated. And then different substations, which are part of the different microgrid, can communicate to each other and can dispatch the information from one grid to the other so that there is a market that can be transferred from one local grid to another local grid. And eventually, it becomes possible to just connect all those microgrids in order to get a much broader global microgrid.
Thank you, Primavera.
Thank you.